It is basically consisting of three major parts: hopper assembly, body, and then bed plate. Hopper is a device, a provision for us where we can charge raw materials, and then body is the main process, main part of the machine where the process of mixing is taking place. And then bed plate is a robust in construction which will prevent the vibrations of the machine, and at the same time we can also discharge the materials from this particular section. So these are the three ways, three sections of the Banbury mixture. Okay, so here if you see from the top, this is a cylinder, and then this is our V shape mixture. There, this is called as the floating weight, and this can move in this fashion. It can go top, it can come down. So here we fill the air, so hence we call it as pneumatically operated floating weight. So by controlling the air in this particular chamber, for your information, the machines can be operated by means of two ways: pneumatic machines and hydraulic machines. Pneumatic machines will be operating because of instrumentation air. Instrumentation air is the air which is free from moisture content and other ingredients which may damage the metal of construction of the precious instrumentation process control items. We use the same thing in our factory. We use an absorption cell to make the instrumentation air. And then this air will be used to drive the machine. So hence the machines are called as pneumatic machines. On the vice versa, we have a oil operated, compressed oil SM, and with the help of compressed oil, the machines will be operating. And these machines are called as hydraulic machines. But in majority of our chemical industries, where instrumentation process control is involved, we use only instrumentation air. So what is instrumentation air? Air which is free from moisture, so that it do not trigger, it do not cause corrosion. At the same time, unwanted ingredients which are present in the air, they are removed, so that the air is not damaging the costly machinery, valves, etc., which are there in our process industry. So if the pressure of the air in this chamber is more, what will happen? The floating weight comes down. And if the pressure is reduced, the weight goes up. So the basic purpose of this is to give a motion which can move in the top direction, bottom direction, the floating weight. And this is a manhole. I will open this manhole physically. And then through this, I will charge the materials. The material will come and fall here. And then I will close it. Then what I will do is, we will apply pressure here. When you apply pressure, what will happen? As I said, that this shaft will come down, and this floating weight, which is having V shape, it will try to come to the bottom. So here it will come and then lock itself. So once it comes and locks, what? These are the two shafts: rotor, mixing chamber. This is the mixing chamber, and hydraulically operated discharge door assembly. I'll tell you. And then toggle latch mechanism, bed plate. So this rotor will be carrying the needles, and here the casing is also having a teeth. So you can imagine how the mixing action is induced for mixing materials. And because of this intensiveness, the name itself is called the intensive mixer. So once the materials are added, okay, we will be lowering this arm. The weight will come, and here it will be the dead end of this. It will close perfectly, and then we'll start the machine. So these two will be rotating. One will be rotating clockwise, another anti-clockwise direction, and the mixing takes place. After the mixing is over, this is hydraulically operated bottom plate. So when you start this, what will happen? This chain, this part which you are seeing here, having a trough one here, it will try to come down. When it comes down, what will happen? After the mixing is over, the material will fall onto the floor, and from there it will be discharged out. And then again, this will be on the closer, and then completes the volume, and then we lower this weight, and then we can charge the material. So like the continuously, the mixing will take place, and then after the mixing is over, we will take it out. So rotor, and then this is called as the mixing chamber. And this entire setup of raising and lowering the bed is called as, is done by means of hydraulic machinery. So bed plate is what? Which is a robust in nature, which will absorb all the vibrations so that the loss of energies, and then the machine will function significantly. This is called as Banbury internal mixture. Because of complexities, they won't ask this in the final examination. Don't worry about it. But since we had seen the concept of Banbury mixture, so I'm just giving you an idea of this Banbury mixture as is told in the previous class. Then we have seen the, how to say, the videos. Now let us see the theory part. Continuous kneaders. The mesh kneaders are what? Kneaders are those machines which will have plates, sigma plates, disposer plates, and double navel plates. And at the bottom, you have an extruder shaft which can rotate in left hand direction and then even in the right hand side directions. So, hence, what will happen, sir? We will be using one of this. So the machines just describe, no, so that is the kneader, which is having a shaft at the bottom, which is having helical patterns of mixing specimens. Then of course it is also called an extruder, which can also rotate in left hand side to right hand side and the clockwise direction. Or if it is rotating in the anti-clockwise direction, it can pull the material from right hand side to left hand side. So that we have a concept of rigorous mixing. The machine just described above operate batch wise. And the two relatively small amounts of materials. As you seen the capacities in the previous video, it was only 100 kgs. 100 kgs is a small size in our chemical industry where we use tons of materials for process. So hence, we use two or three machines so that our productivity will increase. But the first thing is what? It is a batch process. And then its volume is also very less to keep the power consumption less. The more difficult The more difficult the material is to mix, the smaller the batch size must be. As I said just now, so if it becomes difficulty in mixing as the viscosity increase, as the penetration is difficult, so hence to reduce the power consumption, the capacity of the machine should be lower. So all the processes, all the equipments are batch size and they are smaller in construction. Many industrial processes are continuous with a steady uniform flow into or out of the units of the equipment. Into such process, batch process is not readily incorporated. But the one thing, how can we make, if you see any of the pharmaceutical industries where the reaction takes place, and then you have to stand in front of the reaction till the reaction takes place. It may be 8 hours or 4 hours or 3 hours, whatever. So it is obviously a batch process. But still we can make it a continuous process by keeping two or three equipments. So cyclically, if you schedule, so first hour this will operate, 4th hour that will operate, 8th hour that will operate, and in a cycle what will happen, continuously we get the material. So any of the pharmaceutical industry if you go, because of the process scheduling, they will be producing continuously the materials. Though the process is a batch process. And why the process is a batch? Because of the complexity in mixing, and then we want to keep the power consumption less. Continuous kneading machines have developed that can handle light to fairly heavy materials. In a typical design, a single horizontal shaft slowly turning in a mixing chamber carries the rows of the teeth arranged in a spiral pattern to move the material through the chamber. This we have seen at the bottom of the container where there was a shaft was there to the shaft what happened. We have helical patterns of blades are introduced and the shaft can rotate clockwise and anti-clockwise directions so that we give a rigorous mixing action to the material. The teeth on the rotor pass through the closed lens between the stationary teeth set in the wall of the casing. these teeth will pass through the clearance between the metal upon structure, so that there is a chance of mixing to take place. And the clearance is there, the metal is there in between the teeth and the bottom container. So hence, when the gap is very less, then mixing will be taking place. Otherwise, what will happen? Sometimes, always one metal will be present without mixing. So clearance is very important. The shaft turns and also reciprocates in the axial direction, which you have seen in the video. Materials between the meshing teeth is therefore smeared in an axial or longitudinal direction, as well as being subjected to radial stress. So these are the forces applied by the helically oriented teeth on the material. Other side is the metal upon structure. So hence the metal upon structure is not moving, whereas the teeth is moving. So hence what will happen? Shearing action will be there on it. Because what are shear forces? Shear forces will be applied between two planes. One is moving in left hand side direction, other may move, may not move, but if it is moving, it should move the right hand side direction. Solids enter the machine near the driven end of the rotor and discharge to the open surrounding of the shaft bearing the opposite end of the mixing chamber. So we end it from the top and then we say that it is mixing will take. The chamber is open rough, as you have seen in majority of the cases. If we are processing harmful materials, then only we are going to close it. If not, we have a visual inspection thoroughly till the mixing is taking place. Majority of the cans, change can mixtures or whatever, they can be opened. The chamber is an open trough with the light solids and a closed cylinder with plastic masks. These machines can mix several tons per hour of heavy, stiff and gummy materials. Heavy in sense of density, stiff in the sense of breathing, and then gummy means it will have tackiness. Mixer extruder. So now we see what is that the one which is rotating at the bottom, which is having helical springs, what it is going to do with this. Mixer extruder, or I gave one example in which the video that only the single shaft will be rotating in enclosing, and then we have added yellow spherical materials and then blue spherical materials. They were melted, mixed properly, then afterwards again some more are added. That is the perfect example of mixer extruder. If the discharge opening of the continuous kneader, if we are reading the theory what you have seen in the videos. If the discharge opening of a continuous kneader is restricted by a covering, yes, the shaft is covered by means of an enclosure. With an extrusion die, the pitch blades of the rotor build up considerable pressure inside the material, because when the volume decreases, automatically the pressure increases. The mix is cut, folded while in the mixing chamber and subjected to additional shear as it flows through the die. So this is what is happening inside the closed chamber. Other mixture extruders function in a similar way. They contain one or two horizontal shafts rotating but not reciprocating. Because if it is reciprocating, of course, we have to take out the shaft and we have to replace it. But this shaft is carrying helical screw, so it can convey the materials, but that will not remember. Carrying a helical or blade set in a helical pattern so that it will push continuously. Pressure is built up by reducing the pitch of the helical near the discharge, reducing the diameter of the mixing chambers or both. So you can also reduce the pitch of the helical means what? I'll show you the video better. Please see this diagram. See, this is the bottom one. And see, the distance between these two is called as the pitch. And this is the helical pattern which is attached on the central shaft. And now we are closing it. So when you close it, when the material enters, it enters a closed compartment and hence it will be pressurized. These two are called as hoppers. So now these which are the material here, and inside this closed container, the shaft will be rotating, which is having the helical blade. And remember, this shaft is not moving. It cannot reciprocate from here. It do not go out from the system. It simply rotates. As it rotates, what will happen? The blades will be pushing the material and the action will be taking place on the material. So now slowly, in a controlled manner, here also we have a helical conveyor is there. So conveyor is a device which doses, which adds the material continuously with a known mass flow rate into the system. So this RPM of the helical blade is also fixed. So this will be added to the system. This is the mixing zone. Remember this. This is the mixing zone. Now we are supposed to mix yellow spherical balls into blue spherical balls. These two are mixed together. For this, even heat is also applied to melt them. So we see that these blades are rotated. We are moving from left hand side to right hand side. It is only because of the helical pattern, not the shaft is rotated, not the shaft is advancing. This is the melting zone. Then after melting, color is changed. Now again we add another ingredient to it, whose color is different. Then after mixing, different color. This is different, this is different. The question is, how do we pressurize this material? It all depends upon how these helical blades are pumping the material into this closed volume. So as the pump, what will happen, since they are present in this small volume, the pressure increases. This is how the pressurization takes place. They contain one or two horizontal shafts. Two shafts can be present, rotating but not reciprocating. Reciprocating means that moving and coming forward, carrying a helix or blade set on a helical pattern. Pressure is built up by reducing the pitch of the helix near the discharge, reducing the diameter of the mixing chambers. How it is possible, sir? To the machine, we cannot change its diameter. Send more amount of volume, so equally the volume increases, thus the pressure builds up like this. Or what? Mixer extruders continuously mix, compound, mix two materials and work thermoplastics. I hope you know the difference between thermoplastics and thermostatics, because thermoplastic will be exhibiting a property of elasticity, and if you, in the due course of manufacturing process, if the temperature and pressures are very high, you get a solid thermostatic. Okay. Douse, clays and other hard to mix materials can be used for this purpose. Some also carry a heating jacket or vapor discharge connections to permit the removal of water or solvent from the material as it is being processed. So in between we have vents where we can remove the gases. If the gases are formed in the due course of mixing and heating, free gases, then they can be removed. If not, we can go with the the common one. Then we see what is the mixing role. This is our main thing, where this You see this one, this is a roll, cylindrical shaft roll. This is the second one. This will be rotating in this direction, this will be rotating in this direction. In between we add the material and the component takes it. These are called as accessories, a safety this is. Because when we charge the materials, our hands may go inside. So in order to avoid that, we keep this place so that the hands will be safe. Now you see the rolls are rotating, the material is pumped here manually. And then the compounding objects are added. See, nothing is exposed, it is totally exposed to the atmosphere. So means what? These kind of machines are used for processing materials which are not causing pollution. If they are causing pollution, then of course they have to be present inside a casing. As far as possible, all are open to the atmosphere of the human beings, and then we can see the how the mixing is taking place. They are very small in size because of the materials which they are handling. They are very tough. So, and then robust in construction because they have to induce high shear actions. There are gloves are there for him. From the bottom it falls and again manually he is taking it out and then adding it to there. Till the mix is complete, given by the QCD department, he will be operating like this. Now you see that the mixed product is slowly changing its texture. Hello? Hello. So the material has changed now. And remember, sometimes depending upon our requirement, these rolls which are there, they will be having internal heat transfer concept. Like we can melt the material, we can also cool the material. So internally it is sent so that the temperatures can be controlled. If you want to give heat to it, we can give steel to it or electrical power supply to it. Or suppose if you want to cool it, we can send a coolant to it. It all depends upon the nature of the materials which we are fixing. So these are all built in this equipment only. As I said, that mixing is an art, not a science. So it all depends upon the operators and then to what extent we are supposed to mix them to get our desired product's characteristics. Here you see one roll is rotating, the other one may rotate or may not rotate. So and then one may rotate with different RPM. So all these provisions are to be provided in the machine. See, is adjusting the clearance between the roles. This can also be done. Remember this. With the help of VS2, you can adjust the clearance between the roles. So as he tries to rotate this, the clearance decreases and the induced pressure on the material increases depending upon our requirement. So it is first important thing is to study the characteristics of the materials is very important. Then what type of action you are going to give it to is for mixing, that depends upon our experimental studies. Latex type of material is obtained here. The last video. See, the action is simple. Two roles are there. See how much amount of active equipments are involved in it. Because what type of power we are going to give to them is a bigger one. They are rotating. Yeah, now they add the material. It's coming out. One more. So he's rolling it and take it out. Manually he is charging it. So now we have seen the videos of a mixing roll. Let us see the theory part. Another way of subjecting paste and deformable solids to intense shear is to pass them between smooth metal rolling, turning at different speeds. I told that two rolls may be different at different speeds or same speeds. They may have an internal provision for heat transfer for heating or cooling. By repeated passes, so you have seen that the operator was taking out the material from the bottom and then is again adding to ensure that a compound mixing is possible till it exhibits the desired characteristics. He will be repeating this process, and this is a batch process. By repeated passes between such mixing rolls, solid additives can be thoroughly dispersed into a pasty or a stiff plastic masses. Now, continuous mills for mixing paste contain 3 to 5 horizontal rolls set one above the other. Here in the configuration, you have seen only one set of
role pays. One set of pay roles. But if you go for the other one, continuous one, below this one more will be there, below this one more will be there, below this one, like that four horizontal pairs are added for a continuous basis. So that once we add the material, we satisfactorily take it out. Continuous mill for mixing contain, mixing paste contain 3 to 5 horizontal rolls set one above the other in a vertical stack. So one after one above the other in the stack we are going to keep it. The paste passes from slow rolls to successfully faster ones. So faster one induces high shear. The rubber products and paste can be compounded on a batch roll mills with two rolls set in the same horizontal plane, which was shown in the video. Solids are picked by the faster rolls and cut in an angle by an operator and then folded back into the bite roll between the rolls. Of course, this provision is not shown here, but if you are going to mix another ingredient, then he has to do this. Additives are sprinkled on the material as it is doing work. Yes, from the top we can shower it, because depending upon our the additives which are added, we can add. What are additives, sir, which increases the elasticity, plasticity, or desired characteristics of a final product are called as additives. Even lubricating oil is also added for smoothness. If you touch any of the plastic materials, you have a smooth finish and friction will be very less, because we see in our chemical technology that we will also add lubricating oils in a trace quantities to it. Batch roll mills require long mixing times and careful attention by the operator, who is continuously standing in front of it and he has to observe the process till it takes place, and have largely been displaced by internal mixers and continuous mills. So this was replaced by the batch process replaced, and we have internal mixers and continuous mills as you have seen in the previous slides. But still, majority of industries they go for the batch process only, because in India we have large manpower is available. Then the Muller mixer. So this is an example of a Muller mixer. If you remember this, immediately you remember the wet grinder which is there in your house. But dear children, in your house you have wet grinder. The wet grinder can will be rotating. The wheels will not rotate. They are free to revolve, but they will not rotate. But here it is different. So we have a stationary pan. The pan is not rotating here. Okay. But these are called as the Muller wheels. So in your house we have a different shape, conical type of wheels are there, but here we have a circular type of wheels, and of course we have a central machine, central shaft. At the bottom we have a electrical machine, and with the help of this electrical motor, this setup will be rotating, and the plows are there. Okay, this we try, we can adjust down so that when we send the motor up, it scraps the material which has been sticked in between the metal of construction and then these Muller wheels. So we charge our materials like this, and then we start the machine. So the Muller wheels will be rotating like this. But at the same time, this will also revolve like this, remember. So first axis is what? This will rotate, this entire setup will move like this. At the same time, this wheel also rotates like this. So when it is rotating, what happens, sir? It applies shear forces on the objects which are present below. And then this scrap, this plows, will scrap it and then again bring to the door of machinery, mixing zone. Okay? That is what is happening in the Muller wheels. Let us see the theory part. A Muller gives a distinctive different mixing action from that of the other machines. Mulling is a smearing or rubbing action similar to that in the motor or the piston. So we have the when we try to mix rubber compounds and ingredients to it, and when the materials are having, when we are supposed to apply high amount of shear forces, we apply this. And if any amount of solids are to be incorporated, we use this. In a large scale processing, this action is given by a wide heavy wheels of Muller as shown below. In this particular design of Muller, the pan is stationary, this is not moving, and the central vertical shaft is driven. Okay, this is the central vertical shaft which is driven by means of electrical machine which is present below, causing the Muller wheels to roll on circular path over the layers of the solids, which are solids on the pan floor. So on the inside the pan, which are the materials, and as we are rotating, layers of the solids will be formed, whether it is a small solids or is it elastic material, anything. It is small layers will be formed at the bottom, and this will be scrapped by the plows. The rubbing action results from the slip of the wheels on the solids as the wheels are continuously rotating. Plows guide the solids under the Muller wheels or to an opening in the pan floor at the end of the cycle when the mixer is being discharged. In another design, the axis of the wheel is held stationary and the pan is rotated. So in our house, we have this one. The wheels will not rotate, but of course, the pan will be rotating it. In still another, the wheels are not centered and the pan, but offset. And both the pan and the other wheels are driven. So here, it is centrally located. In some cases, it is off-centered, where the Muller wheels be rotating, the pan is not rotating. Where in the second case, the pan will be rotating, Muller wheels will not be rotating. So with the same diagram, we can draw four diagrams. First one is what? The Muller wheels is not, this is not rotating, this system is not rotating. Pan will rotate. In the second case, pan will not rotate, this system will rotate. In the third case, this is not at the central axis, but the pan is not rotating. Last case, not central axis, but this is rotating, pan is rotating. So four combinations we can derive from this, depending upon the nature of the material. Mixing ploughs may be substituted for motor wheels to give what is called as a pan mixture, which is there, okay, where we need not scrap the material. Mullers are good mixers for batches of heavy solids and paste, which can be mixed together. They are especially effective in uniform coating the materials of granular solids with a small amount of the liquids. A continuous Muller mixer with the two mixing pans connected in series are also available. So from here, after the mixing over, it goes to the second system, where on a continuous basis, once we charge the material from the second one, we get it out. Now, when we see a video, we'll understand this logic once again. This is the bottom electrical machine starter. Can is not rotating, whereas here the mullers are rotating. The ploughs scrap the cake material which are sticking and then bring back to the vicinity of the mixing zone. Solids are mixing plastic masses. Here also the mixing is open. The operator can see. So he has shown four, so that the size of the batch increases. This is the electrical motor. This is the starter. Every motor should have a starter. I hope you know what is the significance of a starter. Initially, it prevents flow of high currents into the system so that the windings will not damage. So once the flow has come to, once the system has come to steady state, then of course it will lower its resistance. The full current flows to the electrical machine. So every electrical machine in our industry, you will have a starter. Plus all the motors are flame-proof motors because they don't generate any amount of sparks. If they generate any amount of spark, there is a chance that if the volatile carbons which are present, they may catch the fire. So all the machines, all the electrical machines which are used in a chemical industry are termed as flame-proof motors. They cannot even generate a small spark. And every motor should have a starter. Why, sir? A starter is a device. Initially, the resistance is very high. It allows the flow of less amount of current to the machine so that the windings are not damaged. And at the same time, as time passes, immediately the resistance will be reduced. And then the full supply of the current will go and the machine will come to steady state. This is what is done in the starter. Now the material will be discharged. So it is discharged on the floor. So you can imagine the importance of the material. Then the second.
which is the outlet discharge, where the plows will play a vital role in pushing out the materials. So already materials are added to it. In this also can is not rotating, Muller wheels are rotating, two Muller wheels, and these are the plows. Plow, yeah, plow. This is the second one. So in the back they are collecting the materials. So this is about the Muller mixer. Then the last mixer will be a pug mill. Before we see one, let us see one video. Pug mill is used for homogenizing clays. So the raw clay is brought and dumped into the pug mill, and that will be homogenized. Yes. And see from here, from the bottom, we get the material. Start the machine. He got, this is called as a pug, P-U-G, pug. Again, he is mixing for uniformity. This is the top view, material mixing, blades. It's a slow RPM, but imagine the power it is giving to this material, composite material. That is important. Because of it, we call these as machines are versatile machines. See, the pug is coming slowly, it bubbles from the bottom after mixing, after uniform mixing. If it is not satisfied, again this will be dumped into the main inlet. The second one comes. We have the last diagram for the part. Homogenizing clays is used this. He's cutting it. Starter. On building up of the pressure, open the discharge manhole, add the slices of the clays to be homogenized.
and then continuous is coming out. So this can be termed as a continuous mixture. It is kept on a canvas floor so that there is no question of tackiness. Continuously it will be going out. So this roll will rotate and then this puck will move. Having a small thread here which will cut it. Yeah. Again, he wants to homogenize it. The blades, remember, they don't even mix, they also create a shear and they should also push the material so that it comes out from the system through a circular orifice. Thus a cylindrical shape is continuously coming out. Okay. This is about the puck mill. Let us see. In a puck mill, the mixing is done by blades or knives set in a helical pattern. We have seen this on a horizontal shaft, turning in an open trough. Yes, it is. It can be open trough or closed trough. He has opened the lid and then he has added the material. It will become a closed cylinder. Solids continuously enter from one end of the mixing chamber and discharge from the other end. This we have seen in the second video. While in the chamber, they are cut, mixed, and moved to be acted upon by each successive blade. A single shaft mill utilizes an enclosed mixing chamber. Open trough double shaft mills. We have only single shaft mill. Are used for more rapid, more thorough mixing is required. The chamber of the most enclosed mill is cylindrical, because we are getting a cylindrical product from the outlet. But in some, it is a polygonal in cross-sectional to prevent sticky solids from getting on the shaft. Blend or home is the only purpose of it. From there, they go to various purposes. Breaking. Yeah. Break of agglomerates in the plastic solids and mix liquids with solids to form very thick and heavy slurries. Majority using of this. Sometimes they have to remove the slurries. Seeing here, pressure has come up to negative. We have removed and actually they will dissolve inside the place. They are built up with jackets for heating or cooling depending upon our requirement. This will be there.